I play Celeste Lyons, who's married to Stephen Lyons. And they're sort of like a nuclear in and of themselves, actually, the Celeste and her children and Stephen. But it's forced to sort of mingle and be a part of that whole larger family. Within their sort of own little unit, she's a driving force, she's a powerhouse, and it rules the roost. This is the second thing that I've worked on with Russell T. Davies, and the man's a genius. You know, he'll have you laughing one minute, and you know, the next minute you're in fits of tears, and you never know quite where what's going to happen next. It's so personable, his writing. Yeah, it's and funny, very bloody funny.
Rory, it's fantastic to have you joining us as well now. I guess the obvious question, can you talk about what it was about this script and this type of family drama that most interested you as a storyteller when you first saw the script?
Well, there are very few times in one's career, or at least mine, where you finish something within about half an hour, you think, yes. And I think Black Mirror was one of them, which made me just think, if this isn't brilliant, it's going to be our fault or my fault, because on the page it's incredible. And this is probably the one since then where immediately you thought, this feels so distinctive, so current, and so sort of novel feeling. Immediately you wanted to be involved with it.
Obviously, I mean, much like Black Mirror, this feels like a series that's going to hold up a bit of a mirror to our society and where we are now, where we're maybe heading. Can you talk a little bit about some of the themes, the subtext? Because obviously this is about one family, but it's about so much more than that, it feels as well, just from what we already know.
Yeah, I mean, it is about, even though we fast forward quite quickly to 5 years, then through 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 years, and then ending up 15 years, it is speaking about today and our projections and our fears and our hopes and our dreams of what the future might look like. I think, in particular, you know, at the moment in our lives, there is such uncertainty, both, you know, worldwide and nationally, that it's a time where we're all looking at what life might be like, how we will survive, how will we go through in the next sort of decade or so. And it's, you know, one man's vision of what that might be, but it's so beautifully drawn, and it's not all depressing. It's, you know, it's funny, it's inspirational, it's hopeful, and it's full of the love that binds family together and that draws people together.
It was really interesting, actually, because I, you know, initially, because we are going over the course of 15 years, had this whole thing planned and did a timeline and sort of mapped out that journey. But of course, on the day, you never shoot in sequence. You sort of just had to deal with what was on the page, you know, respond emotionally to what was on the page on that particular day. Yeah, shooting day.
I think also being able to follow a relationship, and particularly a rather than just a family relationship, a relationship between partners over that period of time, you have to have built up what that relationship was before you start the previous 15 years of their knowing each other, and then work, I guess, work out, you know, if you're in episode 3, that's 2024, so, or 2026, so what happened in 2024, and there's a bit of mental arithmetic that you had to work out in between scenes, because quite often you were shifting between 26 and 28 and 24 all in the space of a day. But my secret weapon for remembering where I was is that in 2024 I had about this much hair, in 2025 I had about this much hair, and onwards. And if I knew that I was bald on top, I was moving on into episode 4 or 5.
Yes.
Obviously, Rory, you've had the good fortune to work with so many fantastic writers and storytellers. Can you talk about what makes Russell T. Davies such a very unique and precious talent?
I think the most sort of obvious preciousness, not his smarts or his imagination or his complete sort of inside-out knowledge of how TV works, is that he has an instinct for the popular, and how he manages to weave in such intelligence, such heart, such warmth and wit, all things that an audience loves, but also quite often with quite a dynamic message and quite a dynamic vision. You think Queer as Folk was at that time fairly groundbreaking television, and yet it didn't necessarily feel that way because there was such universal truth to all the characters, and the way that they were drawn was so easily accessible, and how he manages to tackle challenging, diverse themes, but at the same time do it in such a digestible and relatable way is, I think, what makes him unique.
So much excitement about Bond, as there always is. I'm curious, we already know that Daniel is going to be moving on and this is going to be his final outing. But I think the one question I think a lot of fans have been asking is, will this also be the last outing for the Bond family that's been built around Daniel? I mean, I know this is very early in the process for you, but do you have the sense that this would be your last time with the rest of that team, or do you think you might go beyond Daniel's last outing?
I've felt it's the last one for me every single time I've made one. So in that, this is no different from all the others. You never know if you're going to be in the next one, so this has been the same as them all.
So you talked about what makes Russell such a very special storyteller. Obviously, there's been a change of guard with Bond 25. Carrie coming on board, I think those has re-excited people. Are you excited about getting a chance to work with him? Obviously, a very exciting director.
Yeah, I mean, I haven't worked with him before, and I love some of the stuff that he's done. So, we can't wait to get going.